one of the important things that we think that we have to face here, because it's timely and it's very critical and crucial for many aspects. What did the Second World War do to the Western world? What happened, if anything, to the Western world after the Second World War? The Second World War was an enormous event, and some say it was really a continuity of the First World War, whatever you want to call it. This was a time the whole world was turned upside down. Moshe went from the Tsar, and then it went to the Communists, then the fights with the Nazis, and Germany went Nazi. The whole world was, whole world. And American soldiers were in some forsaken island where they had all types of huge insects, I mean, in the Pacific. It was like unbelievable what went on. This was a traumatic event. What happened from this traumatic event? I think, again, I'm speaking as a scholar, about trying to arouse any passions. If you arouse passions, you can't be a scholar, you can't think. What happened? And what happened was that the religions of the West realized they're in big trouble. Hitler built on the Protestant hate of Jews. Martin Luther and Hitler spoke the same tongue, the same hate. Luther not only aroused hate against Jews, he was a professional hater. He wanted to destroy the peasants. What are peasants? Poverty-stricken people, beaten and tortured by the counts, and their women and daughters were, don't ask what happened with them. They were nothings. They were like dogs. And they rebelled. And Luther said, we must destroy the peasants. Now, he knew how to speak, you know. When he spoke about the peasants, everybody wanted to get a knife and go out and kill the peasants. And they did. They killed the peasants. The peasants, a lot of dead bodies all over the place. And Luther said, yes! Yes! He was enthralled by this killing. And Hitler came along and did this work. He learned how to turn people in Germany on to hate. And they were used to it from Luther. And Luther didn't begin the process of hate, because it goes all the way back. Even in the earliest time of the church, there were different sects. Some said this is the religion, some said that's the religion. They had wars, and the blood flowed, and hate, and killing, and hate, and killing. The church is full of this. And the Protestant against Catholic, 30-year war, 100-year war, slaughters and slaughters and slaughters. At the end of the Second World War, people said, what's going to be over here? How long is this hate going to go on? In Western Europe, they decided to get rid of religion. Get rid of it. In England, a politician never mentions the name of God. Never talks about God. Because God is a threat to human life in Europe. The wars between Catholic France and Protestant Germany and Spain, and the whole scene of hate and killing. Western Europe says, no more. We don't want to hear the word God. And so, you know, without God, you don't have family. And the family is disappearing. So Europe is disappearing. But this is what's happening. This is what Europe did. Now, what did America do? And what did the great religions do? The great religions, the Catholics and the Protestants, they did two different things to answer the question everyone was asking. You have a hand in this killing and hate. You promoted hate of those who don't believe as you do. Just very close to the Second World War, there was a priest in America that used to speak the most hateful things. And the Vatican was embarrassed. They tried to pull strings, but there was a lot of hate going on. And America was very public. So the great religions had to deal with this. What the Catholics did, they decided to show that they're going to change their theology. They're going to change their theology. Until then, the theology was take a Jew and cook him. Well, that's not a nice thing. Let's not make jokes of this. But anyway, I don't know how to say it nicely, what they decided to do with Jews. That was the old religion. And then they decided, no, Vatican, the Council of the Vatican, and they brought in a liberal pope, and they really showed their face that they're really liberal now, whatever. Okay. The Protestants did not change their theology. The Protestant did something else. They said, our theology remains the same as it always was. This one will burn in hell and that one will burn in hell. I think the Catholics will also burn in hell. Whoever doesn't believe like them will burn in hell. But people are going to say, you're a friend of Hitler. What is this? That's what brought Hitler. You're a hater. No, we love Jews. We're going to support them. The state of Israel. Now, what do they have to do with the state of Israel? The religion is that Jews will burn in hell. All the Jews in Israel are going to burn in hell because they don't accept their Savior. So they say, oh, we're going to support Israel because when our Savior comes, all the Jews in Israel will accept him. It has nothing to do with love of Jews. It's part of their religion. Their religion believes that there cannot be a success of Christianity until the Jews are forced to convert. That's their religion. And they tried it for many years to pressure the Jews to convert. And they say, we're going to support Israel so our Savior will come and the Jews will convert. Now you tell me that's loving Jews. Believe me, I'm terrified of such a love. So my point here intellectually is that after the Second World War, the great religions, Catholicism and the Protestant religions that were responsible for the hate that brought Hitler to destroy the Jews and other minorities, they were facing great condemnation from the public, and they made their moves. The Catholic changed the theology, and they said Jews are not damned the way we used to believe, and the Protestants didn't change their theology. They still said Jews will burn in hell for not believing, but let's be friends of Israel, let's befriend Jews. Okay. And I say, let's understand what is happening. That's all I'm saying. I'm not commenting if it's good, bad, or otherwise. Let's just call a spade a spade. The Catholics have changed their religion. Does that mean that if you go to the Vatican that and you're Jewish, they're going to come out and kiss you? That does not mean that at all. The Protestants, again, I deal with certain right-wing causes. We fight gays and these things. I work with Christian clergy. I've been on the major radio shows, the Christian clergy, and I feel I'm their friend, they're my friend. I once made a radio show with a Catholic priest. I have nothing personal, but I'm saying as a scholar, I'm trying to tell people what's going to happen when the Messiah comes, and God's going to say, where were you? Why did you make up these religions that say that I don't love the Jews anymore? And people will say, well, we never heard from the rabbi told us that there was a problem with that. I told you there was a problem. That's what I want to do. So I'm responding now to the Christian fundamentalist who asks what's wrong with having theological differences. My dear friend, when you say that I'm going to burn in hell because I'm a Jew, that's not a theological difference. That's worse. Now, it's only a theological difference. It's possible that you consider it only a theological difference because somehow you feel that's not offensive. My religion is that you'll burn in hell, and your religion, I should burn, whatever it is. I mean, that could be a way of life. I mean, people can live like that. I'm very disappointed at that kind of style. I would like to live a life where I respect you from my theological perspective, that you're a person. My religion says every non-Jew has a divine soul. The whole world will praise God. When the Messiah comes, God's going to say, look, I didn't create the world for Jews. I created the world for the 70 nations, not for the Jews. The Jews are a light to the nations. They're a clergy to the nations. They're a special people. But the clergy, they don't have this world. They have obligations. Let them study Torah. Let them pray. The people that own the world that have the good things in their life, the big estates, they're not clergy. So the same thing is the Jews don't own the world or don't have the pleasures of the world. They're wandering, exiled people, they turn to God. That's the clergy, and God loves that. But the world itself is not Jewish.